I recently saw a documentary on the attorney William Kunstler. Now, I had known William Kunstler only from his defense of the Chicago Seven, and I knew that he brought up a case where a young man had burned a flag and been arrested and went all the way to the Supreme Court, and Kunstler talked to the Supreme Court about right to burn the flag. I wasn't too clear, if at all. I didn't possess any real knowledge of the cases he handled after those two very famous ones, although there was one that was in the back of my mind, and I think it was the one he did after the flag burning, where this guy in New York had shot six cops. And Kunstler pleaded that he was defending himself, shot six cops. And Kunstler won. And it was the only case in history where somebody had prevailed in the shooting of cops. And Kunstler's career, after that point, took a turn for, I have to say, the celebrity. He appeared on the Phil Donahue Show, and he started taking cases that were, he was no longer even looking at it from the aspect of how guilty is the person I'm defending. I think he was looking at it from the aspect of, can I win, and can I make some headlines? The documentary, and his own daughter was talking about this, how it seemed like there was definitely an aspect of him, especially later in life, where he was interested in showmanship as an attorney, and arguing for the sake of winning rather than arguing for the sake of justice. Or I'm putting words into the mouth of this documentary, I'm just giving a paraphrasing of what I gleaned from it, but it seemed like he was more interested in the showmanship aspect than whether or not he believed any particular thing about it, you know. Many New York City drug lords, crime lords, Kunstler was seen hugging John Gotti outside of some restaurant or some place, and all that stuff for what was portrayed to be Kunstler's own image, Kunstler's own fame. So, I guess in the back of my mind, you know, germinating has been the idea of anybody who has talent or an ability or an opportunity, and we just glean success from it, you know, who has been able to make progress in their chosen practice, profession, then taking it to a level where they're essentially playing the game with themselves, you know, a golfer trying to beat his own best on the course rather than playing with golfing partners and trying to get along. I wonder if we ever become our own private counselors out there in life, in the things that we feel secure in, and the things that we feel we know we can handle and that we're experts in. Does it ever develop almost a case of inbreeding, almost a case of practical genetics when it comes to our habits? Do we ever take it to the point of it being a narrower focus on, oh hell, you know, my interest here is if I can win. You know, my interest here is not necessarily how does this jibe with what I believed in when I was a younger man. My interest is not necessarily in, you know, who do I feel has the juster cause. My interest is in whether I feel I could win. That kind of mentality, that kind of attitude. I have to conclude, by and large, yes, there are times when most of us are our own private counselors. We are able, first of all, I guess the foundation is feeling comfortable. You have to feel comfortable enough in what you're doing to take the kind of risks, to go on the kind of edges where pulling yourself back from it, you know, into the center, into the rightness, is a feat, you know, where it's something that's unusual. So there's an aspect of humanity that almost relishes that kind of showmanship. And it's not necessarily for the purpose of striving for good. It's more for the purpose of performance benchmarks. And it's really rather perverse when you look at it. It's almost what you would imagine a mentality that a sentient being who's been around for thousands and thousands of years might take, almost like a god mentality of, I've been there, I've done that, you know, I've done that a thousand ways to Tuesday, and now I'm interested in seeing, just for the sake of it, can I beat my high score in the game, you know? And doing that sometimes involves moves within the so-called game that are not necessarily in the interests of sportsmanship, you know? Camaraderie, none of that sort of all gets hung out the window for a time while you're focused on beating your high score. Another aspect to be brought into this is that whole video game mentality. You know, there's a generation that grew up without video games, and then this generation where there was a transition, which is what I'm in, and then a whole generation after me that was immersed in video game simulated reality. And to win in a lot of those games, they have different terms for it. If you're in an adventure game and you want to rack up points and gold and stuff, you run around the countryside killing trolls, and you kill and you slaughter, and, you know, so presumably they're all bad guys, but it there's nothing to do with, you know, what just cause, you know, what happened, you know, did they attack you first? Nothing like that. It's just killing them to rack up whatever was in their purse, and whatever credit, you know, doing that gets you. And I can't help but see bleed over, you know, carry over into life, into real life, more and more. Now, competitively, it could be a positive. Competitively, it could be a boon. You could say, this is what drives innovation, the desire to beat that high score, you know, to make that processor that's more powerful, you know, to make that motherboard that can take all sorts of memory and cards. And, or you could say, where do we detach from practicality? You know, in the application of our own daily processing, in the application of how we take in the world around us, when are we just playing with ourselves? When are we just being our own private counselors in order to do the self-affirming thing, to do the ego-boosting showmanship thing of trouncing, winning, the concept of victory, whether it be just a simple jibe that somebody does not have a retort to, or whether it's something more serious, more permanent, more harm-inflicting, more lasting. Wish I could clearly see all the motivations behind actions of that nature, even if they're just limited to myself and my own motivations. Therein lies a certain amount of wisdom.